Okay, so this is how you create a segment for your email marketing campaigns. So you would go in here and you have to find segments in here. So you can create segments based on your contacts. So the contacts you have on your CRM. So you have two options here. You can create a dynamic segment or you can create a static segment. For static segments, what it means is you're gonna have, you're gonna add contacts here and that's how it's gonna stay, right? That's why it's called static. So when you add, let's say you are at 5 or 10 or 100,000, whatever, you're gonna have to do this manually and then that's how it's gonna stay. So we can say here, test 11. You save it, and then you're gonna come in here, and it's gonna, you're gonna have two options basically. You can add just in here, kind of one by one. So you can look in your records if you have here, and these are the contacts that we have in our CRM. And you can select one and add it here, or you can go in here and add a new record. So you would add the contact here and then add it, save and then add it. And if not, what you're gonna do is you can add by query. So that's gonna, that means you're not gonna be adding one by one, you're going to be adding, let's say this here based on an attribute that your contacts have. So let's say you want to add everyone that's in Houston, Texas. So then you will be able to add them in here. Let's say this is what you want to do. And you're going to be able to add all these people here. You can select, let's say for some reason you want to leave someone out, then you can select them, or you can just add everyone. And then you will have it in here. So now you can go into your segment and you're going to see the members here. Again, when you save, it means you're saving all the actions you've done so far. But this is, if unless you go live, you're not going to be able to see your segments in the list when you're in the next step, creating your customer journey. So you can, let's say you have to go do something really quick, or you have to go do something else, and then you'll be back to this later or tomorrow, you can save. So that all your changes remain. But until you go live, then you're not gonna be able to use this segment for the next step. And once you go live, you can always come back and edit it. So it's not like you're not gonna be able to make any more changes. You can always come back here. This step here, it's just the final step you need to take in order for it to show later. So let's do our other option, and you can see it in here. So the one we just created, it's in draft right now, so that means it's not going to show later. Let's say you want to do a dynamic segment, then you choose this option here. And for dynamic segments, what it means is you're going to create it right now based on some behaviors or some selections. Or some information your contacts currently have, but this is gonna be updated as needed. So as you, if you have 100 contacts that match your requirements here, let's say you wanna select their birthday yesterday, or they attended an event, or they clicked on a link in your email campaign, and right now you have 100, you might come back to tomorrow or in a week and you might see 110 or 200, because it's just going to keep updating. So this is a good one here, a basic interaction segment. So you can select, you can always skip, but we're gonna use this template for now. So let's say in here, I would like to know, or I would like to include in this segment, people that have seen our latest email campaign on Dynamics. But not only that, I want to know who's interested, who was interested in that information, right? So whoever saw this message and also clicked on the link that I have here, so whoever actually wanted to download it, I want them included in this segment. So I can save it. And we need to add a name. So it can be test 12. I want to save it in here. And if I give it some time, if I go live, first of all, and I give it some time, it's going to show my members in here. We can actually change this to, this is what I was just referring to. I clicked go live, but now I need to edit it. So that's not an issue. I can edit here. And I want to actually select a different one because this one we haven't sent out, so it won't show me any members. So let's say I want to use this one here. To know who clicked on this email, because this is what I'm setting up here, who clicked on this email campaign that I sent. But I also want to know who clicked on this link or this URL that was inside the email, because that means, for me, what that means is they are actually interested. So I want to, if they're clicking, if they're receiving the email, they're opening it, and they're clicking, they're reading, and they're clicking on the information, on the links in, that are inside the email, then that means they're really interested in receiving information that's related to Dynamics 365. So in here I saved, it passed the error check, and I can go to members, and it's going to show me the members here. So this might take some time. What you can do is you can refresh. You can even go outside and try that again. So now it's loading. So there's 288 people that we emailed that received this email, and not only that, but they clicked on this link. So now I know whenever I have more information on Dynamics 365, they're going to probably be interested because they took the time to go into this. So these would be the two main options you have. You can do a lot more with this, especially with the dynamic segment. You can add a lot more behavioral blocks, and you can do a lot more with it. You can segment by city or by behavior, etc. And this is what you want to do in order to be able to send out marketing emails.